If the resultant force of the three force vectors shown in the figure is 450 Newton and it is directed along the positive u axis, we can identify the force vector F1 and the angle phi it is making with respect to y axis utilizing its rectangular components. So to start, we can draw our resultant force Fr of 450 Newton along the positive u axis and then divide this force into its x and y components by projecting the force utilizing the angle 30 degree. Taking the cos function of this angle will project the force 450 Newton along the x-axis, while taking the sine function of the angle 30 will project the force along the y-axis. Once we have the resultant force identified, next we can go ahead and divide individual F1, F2 and F3 along its x and y-axis. So to start, our F1 force is making an angle phi with respect to y-axis. That means if I take the sine function of that angle phi, it will give me my component along the x direction. Whereas if I take the cos function of the angle phi, it will project the force along the y-axis. So one thing to keep in mind, that cos function always project the force vector along the axis from where the angle is being measured. So in this case, since angle phi is measured from y axis, our cos function will project the force F1 along the y axis. Next, I have force F2 that is acting along the x axis, so it will only have the x component and it won't have any y component. Finally, we have our force F3 of 260 Newton. Now, in order to calculate the y component, here we are given the right angle triangle. Multiplying the opposite over the adjacent with the magnitude of the force 260 will give us the y component. Whereas if we multiply the adjacent over the hypotenuse with our force magnitude of 260 will give us our x component. Now one other way of looking at it is, since 12 is parallel to the y axis, so that is utilized in the numerator while we are calculating our component along the y axis. Whereas 5 is parallel to the x axis and we have utilized 5 in the numerator when we are calculating the F3x. Now once we have all the components, we can go ahead and equate the resultant force component along the x direction with the sum of all the force components along the x direction. Here we have our resultant x of 450 cos of 30 that is equals to the x component of force F1 along the x direction, that is F1 sine phi plus 200, and plus our F3x component of 260 times 5 over 13. Next, we can go ahead and simplify this equation, and here we are getting F1 sine phi equals to 89.71. Let's mark this as our equation 1. Next, we can go ahead and repeat the same process, but this time along the y direction. Here we are taking the sine convention upward as positive. So our FRY is equals to 450 sine 30. It can be equated to the sum of all the y components of forces F1, F2 and F3. Here force F2 don't have the y component, so we have only two of those. Now since F1 is going upward, it is taken as positive, whereas the F3y is going in the downward direction, so we have taken here as negative based on our sine convention. Simplifying, we get our equation 2 of F1 cos phi equals to 465. Now once we have both equations figured out, we have two equations and two unknowns, so we can go ahead and easily simplify this thing. One way of doing that is dividing equation 1 with equation 2. If we do that, our force F1 will cancel out and we have sine phi over cosine phi on one side of the equation, whereas on the other side we have a ratio of 89.71 and 465. That ratio of sine phi and cosine phi can be converted into tangent phi. Now taking the tangent inverse, we can figure out our angle. So in this case, it is coming as 10.91. Now, once we have calculated the angle phi, we can use any one of these two equations to calculate our force F1. Here, I'm going to use our equation 1. Now, plugging the phi angle of 10.91 in equation 1 and simplifying, we can get our value of F1. So, dividing 89.71 with sine function of 10.91 give us our value of force as 474 newtons.